Everyone else can join us later. I hope you can see my screen. Okay, so we have to complete the SQL injection lab. So we have already studied all the basic stuff about SQL injection. I mean about DBMS and SQL and what type of SQL injection works are there. So let's move forward with the lab thing. So the very first thing will be error-based SQL injection. So our goal will be to perform the SQL injection activities against error-based SQL injection. So we have to cause the database error, right? We need to return it. The database should return a data using comment, then return data without comment. Order by column testing and force vulnerable query details to display. So we need to do all these steps. Apart from this, we will also play with a couple of tools and we'll also integrate Zap with SQL. So exercise. So you need to, the very first thing, turn on your OBAS broken web app and your attacking machine. So let me do it first. I need to change my network. Network actually, okay, perfect. Okay. That's my attacker machine, this is my victim machine. Let both the machine spin up first. It's my parent. So just again, let me check the IP address. It's 2.10. Perfect. Very first thing I need to do is turn on my browser. I guess that's fine now. 10.0.2.10. There it is. So that job will be set. Let me check the bug first. So first we need to create an error inside the web application. Let's open up utility. Okay, we are going with the error based SQL injection. So to identify that, we need an error. So what we will do, we will insert the admin with this single code and it will give you the error. It can be admin, it can be anything. So like maybe I'll go with root. You can give any input, store, whatever you want. So over here we have the error, and this error will give you a lot of information, especially about the database. So you can see it's using MySQL data server, right? Now the error, why we are facing this error, due to this three quotes. That's the only thing. So by this way, we have identified that this particular machine has error-based SQL injection. Let's go back to the slide and what we need to do next. Second thing, we need to list down all the data. So look at the command here. You will do this admin with single quote, then 1 is equal to 1, which is always true. Then you'll break the command and hash. And by using hash, you will comment down everything else at the back end. So let's do that. I'll enter some random value. It can be like QWER, then this, 1 is equal to 1, break it and hash. Well, when I will go with that, it will list down everything which is inside the database. Oops. I guess I need to insert a valid user. 1 is equal to 1. Okay. What's wrong with that? It was working in the morning when I tried it. Admin, then I need to run equal to 1, break the command, go with that, apart from it, go with that as well. Now, let me open it up in some other app, maybe in this authentication bypass. It's giving me the same error. Okay, there's some issue with the application, I don't know what. Okay, leave it. Because when I was practicing all these things, it was working, but now I don't know what's wrong with that. So it should be 1 is equal to 1, then semicolon, and then space. Hash sign, so it will comment down everything else. Let me try it again with some other options. One is equal to one, break. Okay, that's giving the same thing. So leave it. Then another will be admin, then the single quote, then or command that you will use, and one is equal to one, it will bypass the authentication. Let's try that out. It's giving me bad username. Let me try it here. Bypass authentication.
Hello.
Yeah.
सर एक छोटा सा इंट्रो दे दो कि अभी आप कर क्या रहे हैं क्योंकि मैं अभी कॉलेज से पहुंचा
हूं योर नेम
सर गौरव
ओके गौरव बेसिक वही एक्सरसाइज चल रही है अभी स्टार्ट करा था मैंने
आई स्टार्टेड एसक्यूएल इंजेक्शन
लैब तो ये थोड़ा टास्क बताया था मैंने कि करना क्या है एंड देन वी वर डूइंग द टास्क ओके सर बाईपास द ऑथेंटिकेशन
ओके
mistake is here or and then this let's try that out okay so we are now logged in as admin so we so with this particular command over here this one or command either admin or 1 is equal to 1 so 1 is equal to 1 is always true and we use the single quote here because there will be second quote at the end of the command automatically the script will automatically append that thing right so this will bypass the authentication this is supposed to list down the all the data inside a MySQL database but it's not working then we have again this command so over here order by 4 so it will look into the fourth number table inside the database so you can use 5 6 7 8 whatever you want then this one is over here the union select So these will be the line table numbers. 1234 hash. So you are actually like trying to execute multiple things, and at the end, using this hash, you are actually commenting out all that stuff. Let's try that out. By the way, this order by or these needs to be in capital, and you can use like maybe like 2 space 2 and break the command hash. Let's see if it works or not. Okay, it has worked, and here we have the output. So on line number 2, on column number 2, these two users were there. It has listed down all 2, admin, and the signature was got root, then the admin, then the password was 1234, and here we are. Let me try the first command again. Maybe this time it works. Admin 1 is equal to 1, break the command and hash. It's supposed to, it was listing down all the data when I was trying it out. It listed everything, single thing. So let me try user 1 is equal to 1, break the command and hash. I'm doing some mistake maybe. So let's find the one. Let's try it. Maybe it works. No. It's not working. Let's leave that command. The first one. The second one, I mean. This one. There's something wrong. Seriously wrong with this thing. Maybe I used a space, I guess, between the and 1 is equal to 1, break it. No, the results are same actually. Then you, in case of order, you will have the, you can give the order number, the 4, 3, 2, 1, whatever you give, 100. You need to identify that. Maybe like some database have 100 of things, so you can give order by 100. And then union select. So it will also list down the tables. Let's try that out. Admin, then union select, and it's 1 2, and you can break it from 2 and hash. Okay, it's again failed. That's the problem I hear. Let me check what's wrong with this command. Okay. So the admin is complete. 1, 2, hash. And I have got this. This particular code that is causing the problem. That's the only thing which is, it is not completing actually. And by the way, it is not supposed to execute. The reason is I have used hash to comment out everything. Let me try some different thing. And what was that? Union. Okay, at the end. Instead of hash, let's try dash dash. Again, the same thing. So it's the balancing issue. Due to some reason, the command is not balancing, and SQL injection is all about. So I have these two codes, perfect, then these two perfect, then these two perfect, and command breaked here, and everything is commented out. Then why this is executing? That's the problem. So there are three codes at line 2 inside password thing. So it simply means this one also executing. That's why it's 3. Because of, by the way, the whole system should not execute after this. Because I have commented out the stuff. Let's try out something else. We have a lot of commands to execute. So after this basic stuff, let's move to some other important steps. So SQL, like these are the basic things that we have done. After it, we will do all the automation stuff. So like next 20 or 25 slides, we have to learn about the tools, because doing manually things is not a good idea. Like it will consume a lot of time, and every time you will input a certain thing and you have to face a lot of errors and this and that. So better thing is automate this stuff. So SQL injection is a very big and conceptual topic. To understand it in depth, you need to study database management system. So apart from that, I'm sharing a couple of links with you. And these links will give you sound knowledge about various topics of SQL injection. So over here, I'm leaving the topic of blind SQL injection. Off-band SQL injection is not there. So many like 3 or 4 SQL injections, which are like very critical, I'm leaving them. We will study them inside a tool where we are going to automate everything. To learn these critical things and conceptually, you need to follow these links. Over here, you can identify all that stuff. Because if I'm going to... SQL Wiki is a really good site. And this WebSec. Pen Test Monkey needs to be here. Okay. So the first thing is SQL Wiki. So over here, you can understand every single thing, injection types, injection techniques, attack. So they have covered all the things, and it is going to be like big directory for you. You can use it as a cheat sheet. So all four or five topics are here. Then you have this pen test monkey. Come on, it's not working. Okay, so over here, Informix SQL injection cheat sheet, MS SQL cheat sheet, Oracle, MySQL, Postgres. So for different database, you will have a cheat sheet on this particular link. And this. To have all the conceptual knowledge, you can go with this particular page. It will give you all the information about how union-based work, how blind work, how error-based work, how this timing attack works. SQL also has a timing attack. We will explore that timing attack using the SQL map tool. So I'm not going to do it one by one. Otherwise, it will take a lot of time, and it requires a lot. Then we have the stack query. That too we will do in the automation. So let me share the links with you. There's the chat box. So these 3 wikis will be more than enough to cover almost every aspect of SQL injection. Okay. It's time to do automation. SQL injection exploitation tools. So there are so many tools available in Kali Linux and Parrot OS, but unfortunately, majority of them are stopped. Like they are like because inactive projects. So like development has been already stopped. So a lot of tools makes no sense. So like most of the tools are not maintained. So unfortunately, there are not a lot of tools to use. But again, we have only one tool which we can use, and that is SQL Map, which is actively maintained and it's still an active project. And by the way, count SQL Map as an map of SQL injection world. Just like we have Nmap in networking world and it can do everything for you, same SQL Map. It is best for SQL injection. It can do every single thing. Apart from SQL Map, there's a tool named BBQSQL, which is like not active, but it comes on Kali Linux, comes with the Kali Linux. So let's have a slide and let's see how it works. And then we will move to our main tool. That will be SQL Map. So BBQSQL is a Python-based framework to ease and speed the exploitation of blind SQL injection flaws. So it only works on blind SQL injection. By the way, this project is no more active. So like it has all the old libraries and old injection things. So by the way, I don't think it will work in today's world. So it performs two types of blind SQL injection. First is binary based, second is frequency search. Then the attack techniques can be coupled with different indicators. So let's leave this tool. We have nothing to do with that. You can use that if you want. It is, you can find that in Kali or Python, Kali or whichever tool you are using. So I guess it is here, PBQ. Yeah, we have. But this tool is no more active. These are the 3-4 options that it will give you: setup STD parameters, setup BBQ option. Go with the option thing, then it will give you CSV output. Is that nothing that great? When you will open SQL map, you will come to know what is a powerful tool, how a powerful tool looks like. So let's move to the SQL map. So it's an open source Python built command line SQL injection tool with a lot of awesomeness created by Bernardo De Mele. This guy developed this tool, and thanks a lot that he is still working on it. He is still maintaining the project. He is still creating the new versions, adding a lot of new libraries and cheat sheet into it. So if you have a SQL injection task, there is likely a way that SQL map can help you. Even if it cannot be directly used, often using it in a lab that can guide successful testing techniques. By the way, it can do everything for you. Just like nmap, SQL map has all the features which we need, and upcoming, like we have like 50-60 slides here, so we are going to explore the SQL map during all these 22 or 23 slides. So every single command, not every single, but like around 30-40%, we will cover its capabilities. So a few things that you supposed to know about SQL map. The very first thing, it can identify inbound inline SQL injection. It can discover and it can exploit that vulnerability. It can also discover and exploit blind SQL. It is pretty much comfortable with MySQL, MSSQL, Oracle, PostgreSQL, SQLite, MongoDB, and other databases as well. It can be easily integrated with Metasploit frameworks, OWASP, ZAP, Burp Suite, BAF, and other tools. BEEF. I guess W3F, I guess BAF, whatever it is. And it has a lot of features as well. So we are going to explore the feature from next slide. So very first thing, SQL help, SQL map help. So whenever you start a tool, the very first thing that you are supposed to do, let me zoom it a little bit so that it becomes properly visible. I guess that's perfect now. So SQL map, go with hyphen h, and it will give you all the basic commands which you are supposed to know, right? But this is not SQL injection is all about. Like hyphen h for help, then there will be another option, hyphen double h. It will show advanced help message and exit, words and bubbles and so many things. SQL map, go with hh. And here we have a lot of options. Wizard, update, unstable, temp directory, SQL shell, result file, purse, offline, whatnot. So many functions. These are the pre-built scripts actually, which we are seeing under double H. Table prefix, scope, save, whatnot. Now look at the help bar, help list. Let me zoom it out a little bit so that everything is visible. That's perfect now. These are the options here in double edge. Here we go. So it has every single thing which you need to exploit the SQL injection. Along with that, you can also take over the data. You can also take the data item using this tool. Registry keys, we are going to read about registry. You can also take a reverse shell using SQL map, and also interact with the database and operating system as well. So here is the operation, OS command, OS shell, OS spawn. You can also read the operating system files. You can also write files. So a lot of things are possible inside SQL map. See how many options it's giving you. These are the advanced options. So let's go back to slide. So the hyphen HH is OMG features, a lot of things. And hyphen H is all the basic or substantial features. Keep that in mind. So initial targeting. So if you want to run SQL map, very basic, nothing more, much more. Before that, let me define my target. I need my target URL. So utility. Okay, this is going to be my target. Let's divide it. Very basic command will be SQL map hyphen small u and your target URL. Hyphen u stands for URL. Press enter, it will do all the basic stuff. And it's asking like you have not declared cookies. Okay, let's go with that. You will understand cookies in upcoming slides. How you can give the cookies inside, inject the cookies inside SQL map. Target is protected by, okay, it's checking for if there's any web application firewall, IPS or IDS system. It's also discovering the accesses attacks. The page might be vulnerable to cross-site scripting. Testing for SQL injection. Testing for and Boolean-based blind. So you have to study this blind thing a little later. So like before that, you need to understand a database. SQL error based. So it is testing all the basic attacks which it has inside its database. So it's trying everything. It is even trying PostgreSQL, then Microsoft SQL is also there. PostgreSQL is also there. Then the Microsoft Sybase inline, PostgreSQL inline. So, but the basic, we have to configure it to as per our target. Like we have the, it's asking for union test. Okay, let's go with that. Okay, let's stop it here. Try to waste time. Generic union query, null attack. That's the basic thing. Let's move back to the slide. Then you will have that hyphen hyphen crawl to spider your target, just like we were doing in the zap thing. Then you will have the hyphen hyphen form, so target form for injecting attacks. So whichever like web page has a form, like maybe login form or register form, so just give hyphen hyphen form, then the address, and it will do the job. Hyphen hyphen DBMS, so like if you know the database, which database the target is using. So you can give the database name by just hyphen hyphen DBMS equals to MySQL. Let's go back to here. It's still working. Let's cancel it. Skip current test and detection. Next parameter change. Should I quit? Quit. User quit. Otherwise, it is going to take a lot of time. You can perform all the tasks. So let's do the hyphen hyphen crawl thing. Crawl and hyphen u again. And this, by the way, hyphen u will always be there as you have to give the URL. You have to define that this will be the URL, target URL. So I guess I don't have to give the hyphen u. Option hyphen for invalid integer HTTP. What it wants. Sample.co. Even in this case, it's giving you the error. Just a second. Let me check out inside help thing. Crawling is part of DoorDash. CRAWL and then crawl path. I guess I was typing the same stuff. All the websites starting from the target URL. What's wrong there? Invalid integer value. Okay, let's leave it. I don't know what's wrong with that. Let, after crawl will do the spidering thing for you. Then hyphen hyphen form. If you have any form on your website which you want to attack, let me identify some form first. Okay, that login done. Form does not take any value. So I have to go okay. It's testing connection for target URL. And over here it's the PHP thing, we will learn about that. The session token. Do you want to test this form? Yes, of course. Edit post data, default username and password, login. Do you want to fill blank? No. How do you proceed? Continue. So it has identified, looks like the backend DBMS is MySQL. Do you want to skip the test payload specific for the DBMS? When we know that what is backend, so let's move that and skip that thing. For remaining tests, do you want to include all tests for MySQL extending? Yes, of course. Unable to connect to the target URL, SQL map is going to retry again. Reflected value found filtering out. So it was trying this AND boolean blind. So deflected value, what values it find out. So it will try out all the attacks which are stored inside its database, and you don't have to learn anything. Like, you don't have to keep in mind how to post, how the SQL injection attack should be on MySQL or MS SQL or Oracle. This particular tool will do all the automation for you. SQL has got 302 redirect. Okay, do you want to follow? Let's follow. Redirect is the result of a post request. Do you want to resend? No. So it works just like the Zap thing. It properly establishes a communication between the web server and the SQL map, and it starts communicating. It works on the GET and POST request. We do a complete three-way handshake. Unable to connect the URL. Okay, something is injectable. That particular post parameter, this is injectable actually. So it has identified this particular username is MySQL and error base where. Okay, error base it already has. We are having order by, group by, close floor. So error base SQL injection is already there. We already know about it. Apart from this, in most of the blind injection attack, things will be completely blind. You are not going to receive any response from the server. It will be really hard. So you send different parameters to a server, and blind injection is like it is present on almost everything. Almost all the websites have blind injection vulnerability, but it's extremely hard to identify. It's extremely hard to identify the data. The union query null 1 to 20 column. Order by technique appears to be usable. You should reduce blah blah blah. These are the info things. Then this is injectable. So that time-based blind injection, it is the machine is vulnerable to time-based blind injection. Testing for this. So this tool takes a lot of time. Seems to be continuous problem with connection of the target. Are you sure you want to continue? Let's stop it here. And you can continue the test at your home. If union-based SQL injection is detected, please consider and try to force back debugging. Okay, we will learn about this command as well. It is going to try out thousands of commands. So let it work. So we know how the form thing works, and then this hyphen hyphen DBMS. So now we know that our target server has MySQL. So we will give it this particular thing. Hyphen hyphen DBMS is equal to MySQL. So that it only try attacks of MySQL. Unlike it was like in earlier command, it was trying out PostgreSQL, MongoDB, Oracle, then Microsoft SQL, Sybase. It was trying out SQL, then SQLite. It was trying out attack for every database. So if it will try attack for all the database, then we are just wasting our time, right? So better option when we know it has MySQL, only hit for the MySQL. So I'm stopping it here. And let's go back. Can also give this hyphen hyphen DBMS is equals to my SQL space. There we go. Now it will only go with MySQL. Yes, We want to test this form, of course. Do you want to fill blank fields with random data? Yeah. It will do all the tasks, and whatever it will identify, will let you know. Let's move to another slide, because SQL map takes a lot of time. It will ask you for every single thing. Do you want to do this? Do you want to do that? But it gives you the result. The only good thing about it. Okay, let's move to another thing. SQL map, authentication, sessions, and proxies. So if you have already interacted, authenticated to a target, these switches means these commands, these -- thing. These switches can prove useful. So -r or -l, small r, small l, captured HTTP request or proxy log as a starting point can easily help bridge authentication gap. Then you will have -- cookie thing. If you have the session cookie, so you can use that cookie, -- cookies, and that PHP thing. So over here somewhere it was displayed. It was going with the default thing. Here it is. So it was capturing the cookie from the server. So whatever cookie server was giving it to, it was accepting. But suppose we have already authenticated, or we already have a session. So we can copy that cookie, and after giving the option -- cookie, stop it. Over here, what you can do, in the same thing, -- cookie, and cookie, whatever will be the cookie, you can insert, like I'll give it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's my cookie. So if you have a valid cookie, you can go with the valid cookie. If you don't, it's going with this cookie. You want to test? Yeah. Then you have proxy. So now, if you want to connect to your SQL map with Burp Suite, Zap, or any other proxy, you can give the address of that proxy and it will transfer the traffic over there. Let me start Zap first. So if we transfer the data on Zap or somewhere, so it works on, I guess, port number 8080 or something. I'll do all these stuff later. Okay, I'm quitting it, and let's give it some -- proxy. Proxy is equals to, it works on port 8081, I guess. Now it will send all the traffic to unable to connect to a target, connection refuse, or proxy ending. And for testing connection to target URL, unable to connect to your target URL, connection refuse, or proxy SQL map is going to retry. Okay, let me try it again. Maybe we start from here. Proxy equals to HTTP. Let me check if it's working. If it works on 8080 or 8081. Works on 8080. Let me change it to 8080 and let everything just like the same. Yeah, it works on 8080, I guess. Let's see if we have anything. Yeah. See, all the connections are now at Zap is sniffing everything. and you can see in the history whatever communication is going on. You can sniff that. Yes. Now you can capture every single stuff over here and can analyze the data. I will try all the SQL attacks, my SQL attacks. Now I'm sure like you guys know how to work with SQL map. So see, everything is like it's sniffing everything. So let's minimize it and move back to here. Yeah. So we have completed with proxy thing. Move to another thing, that is HTTP headers. So now you know like every time when you communicate within a website it sends a user agent. Now let's see which particular user agent a SQL map is sending. Come here and select anything, look at the request, and the user agent is SQL map. And that's the problem. Why? Because every time it will send the user agent a SQL map, any firewall, IDS, IBS system will easily identify. SQL map means they are trying to exploit the database. So it, without giving it a second chance, the firewall or IDS, IPS or web will immediately drop the traffic. And we don't want that, right? So to mitigate that thing, we have to change the user agent. So for that, we have that. So it is --, --user-agent, and after that you will give the name of user agent. It can be Mozilla Firefox, can be ABC, whatever you want. So let's try out that too. So let's cancel it. We are going to create a big command here. So I'll do here --user-agent equals to Mozilla Firefox. That is fine now, right? So now we will look into the traffic as well, which particular user agent is sending. Yes. Let it start the scanning. Yeah. Now let's look over here. Let's stop again. Yes. Let's come look at the bottom. We need to like see our user agent is now Mozilla Firefox. You can configure that too. Firefox, this Zap gives you a lot of freedom actually. So now --referrer, when we do communication, if we look over here again, so nothing is here about referrer. But you must have seen like if we open up any website, when we do, when we use the website, click here and there, every time we send a referrer thing, right? By the way, you can also copy and paste this cookie inside the cookie thing if you want. Like we have used 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but you can use the cookie thing as well. When it comes to referrer, you need to have the referrer thing. Look, this particular SQL injection attack is going on. Let's decode it. Sending this particular data IMX and 6265 is equal to 6265 and 6462 whatever. So it's giving it the always true value. Leave it. So in referral, like you need to be from which particular web page and give you the referral of this particular page. So that too you can configure --referrer in the page name. So that every time you communicate, you will look legitimate to the web server. That okay, whatever you are like doing, it's legitimate. Like you have been referred by a legitimate page. So you can also leave like referred google.com. That too is possible. Should we try that as well? Or let's move to another slide. Because there's a lot of things which we have to look into. It's asking for 302, okay. This tools takes a lot of time, but again, we'll give you the results. Now, database enumeration. So, --- schema, when you will use this command, it will dump entire DBMS database table and column name, not the data actually. It will give you all the table names and column names, --- schema. Then when you type --- exclude --sysdbs, so it ignores system database. So whatever default database are there inside that database, we all know like demo or sample database, all sample data also comes with the database. When you install MySQL, there will be a sample database. So you are simply saying ignore that sample or sys database. So when you use --dbs, --tables, --columns, these switches can be used to be more tactical than dumping the full list as the schema. So if you don't want the full list like in schema was giving you everything, column names, data table names, but you only want table names, you only want database names, you only want column names. So you can use these as well. Then -d and -t, we will use them, use these commands in an upcoming thing. So -d stands for customer data table. -d for like if you want to look for a specific database, so you can give the name of that database. How you will come to know about the database name? From schema thing, right? And -t, which particular table you want to edit, you want to download, you want to access. So for that you will use -t, capital T and capital D. And it's doing the, I guess, time-based blind injection. Most likely web server has recovered yet, and it is time-based. Yeah, it was doing time-based payload. But it's time-based blind SQL injection. Okay, let's move to another slide. Now, DB data exfiltration. So the ultimate job of attacking a database is taking out the data dump. And that's what we want to do. That's what the hackers want. The only thing that you like is the data dump. So if you have exploited a database, if you have like know all the information, you have access of the database, now your job is to take the dump. So for that, you will use --- all command. And it will dump all the data and metadata. So it will give you the download. Now, if you want to count how many records are there inside the database, you will use --- count thing. Now, if you want to dump only limited stuff, like you don't want the whole database can have a larger size and you don't want it. Maybe it can be a 100 GB database. So downloading 100 GB is not a like easy task, right? It will take time. It depends on the target's bandwidth and your bandwidth, how much time it will take. So in this case, you can select what you want to download. So for that, you will use --- dump. Then you have to give the specific inputs. So using the -d and -t, so you will give like, I want to download that particular table from that particular database. So the --- dump command will bring that particular data for you. Now, if you want everything, just like in all, but you don't want the metadata, so you will use --- dump, then --all. So it will exfiltrate all tables data tables. If you want to search something, then you will use --- search, and then the table database name or whatever string you are giving. You want to search like you have hacked into maybe like Aadhaar card database. Now you want to search the Aadhaar number of Shah Rukh Khan. So you can --- search and then it equals to the name of the person. So it will be like Shah Rukh Khan, and it will list down if that name will be in the database. You can identify that that particular name as well. What continuous problem is connection? Okay. After that, we have like key switches beyond DB data exfiltration. of course, like we know, like we can do the data exfiltration, but apart from that, there's a lot more things that SQL map can do for you. So suppose you want to know the user accounts. So whatever, how many user accounts are there in the database. For that, you will use the hyphen hyphen user, and it will list down all the legitimate users inside the database. Hyphen hyphen password will give you the list of user account and password. The account hashes actually. If they are storing the password in plain text, then the plain text. If the passwords are in hash, then the hash. Now, if you want to read any file, like you want to read the etc password file, so you will use this particular command, hyphen hyphen file hyphen read. If you want to write anything, or if you want to upload anything, hyphen hyphen file hyphen write. Then if you want to change the Windows registry, I do a lot of typos. So if you want to change any kind of registry, or you want to read the Windows registry, so for that hyphen hyphen reg hyphen read, or hyphen hyphen reg hyphen write. Or if you want to add or delete anything, so hyphen hyphen reg hyphen add, and then this for deleting, hyphen del. But the commands are very easy. The tool is very easy. You just need to append everything. Whatever command you want to add, just hyphen hyphen and good to go. It's really beautiful tool with a lot of power. Let's see what it's doing. It's testing out so many things. Do you want to exploit this SQL injection? Okay, it has identified 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. It has Boolean-based blind. Okay, whatever it is. Password, login, submit button. Okay. Then it has error-based and a time-based blind. Do you want to exploit this SQL injection? Let's try out. Okay, I said yes, and what is this? The backend DBMS is MySQL. The backend DBMS MySQL 5.0. You can find results of scanning in multiple targets mode inside the CSV file. Okay. So I need to open this file. Let me copy this address. Let's open that. Okay, it's not going to open. Let's minimize it. Could not, location is not a folder. Okay. Remove that. Okay, we have multiple results. I just, this is the result. Target place parameter technique node. The thing is here. Let's try out another file. The two is blank. That two is blank. The last one will have some data, I guess. Okay, post username bad. It is nothing actually. Just the link and the method and everything. Okay, leave it. We will deal with it later. So you all know how to do these steps. You're pretty much comfortable now. So post exploitation. Suppose now you want to escalate the privilege. Maybe you have exploited database, but you do not have enough privileges. So for that, you will use hyphen hyphen priv hyphen esc. Then if you want to run any query, or you want the shell, so for query hyphen 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 sql hyphen query. Or if you want the operating system shell or the sql shell, then hyphen hyphen sql hyphen shell. So run single command query, get the interactive SQL shell. If you want to deal with the operating system, then hyphen hyphen os hyphen cmd or os shell. Or if you want the metasploit VNC or matter predator backend connection, then hyphen hyphen OS hyphen POM. So it will do the job for you. Now let's move to the lab wala part, which is more important. So goals: employ SQL map and ZAP to test the exploit authenticated SQL injection flow. So you have to manually test authentication SQL injection flow using ZAP. Then integrate SQL map and ZAP application. Provide SQL map authentication information from ZAP. Leverage SQL map and ZAP together to exploit SQLI flow, SQL injection flow. So lab setup will be, you need to use OWASP, ZAP and SQL map. I forgot to mention the SQL map. Then DEM vulnerable, DVWA, against DEM vulnerable bio application from OWASP BWA, and you have to log in into that thing. And then you need to click after authentication, you need to select SQL injection button in the sidebar. Let's look over here. There is the broken DBWI. Does not have DBWI. Okay, you can try out on this app as well. Okay, if you have DBW, you can try out there. If you don't, then perfect. So these are the challenges. Read them by yourself. And I'm taking a 2-minute break. Okay, so now you know what you need to do in the lab thing, right? By the way, it is going to be really easy. It is not that complicated at all. And SQL map is a really easy tool, right? So I hope you have read the whole 6-7 requirements. So I'll give you a little information about all these things, and you have to perform every task on your own. I will not do it online. The reason is SQL map takes a lot of time. Even in case of local network, it will take time. If you go over internet, it will take double or triple time. So better option would be to do it locally. And if we will do it on live, it will take 3-4 hours of time. So the whole lab that you have to do will take around 3-4 hours, maybe 5 hours of time, sometimes even more. So just invest some time and learn about this awesome tool. So the very first exercise is you have to verify the SQL flow. Nothing much, simple. You need to like submit one valid, give it a one valid thing, and then put a single quote. So it will give you the error automatically. So you will identify, okay, it has the error based SQL flow. Second, uh, select the in ZAP, you have to first link the ZAP, and SQL map using the proxy thing inside SQL map. And before that, you need to copy the valid session token, cookie from ZAP and have to paste it inside SQL map. You know how to do it, hyphen hyphen cookie and then the cookie name. The third thing will be, so you need to paste the cookie, hyphen hyphen cookie thing, which you have copied from the ZAP thing. So the command will be like SQL map hyphen u, the URL thing, then the cookie, you have to paste the cookie here, then your proxy will be here and the batch thing. And you have to change the username, user agent as well. Like by default, you will have the SQL map user agent. So changes to any legitimate, I have used 42. You can use Mozilla, Google Chrome, Apple, Safari, whatever you want to use. So that you need to do. Now, censorship table entries. So you need to identify some table entries inside database. So for that, you have to use these commands, hyphen D, and you have to give the database name, hyphen T for customer count. Hyphen D specify the database, T confines it to the customer table, count simply gives you the number of records inside the database. You need to identify that as well. Bahut easy kaam hai. Then you need to identify the users inside a system. So actually you have to read etc password file from the operating system using the hyphen hyphen file hyphen read command. Right? So that too is an easy task. You can do everything at once actually. That too is possible. So you can append all the commands just like we do in nmap. You can do like n number of possible combinations. You can also make all the combinations over here. The only thing, it will consume a little extra RAM, little extra processing power, and a lot of time and efforts as well. After that, you have to observe the output and read the file. Then database usernames and passwords. That's what you need to identify by just appending this command, hyphen hyphen users, hyphen hyphen password, and it will give you the required stuff. Then this is the bonus thing. If you want to do it, you can do it. If you don't, that's perfectly fine. So you need to take a reverse shell of Metasploit, using the Metasploit actually, the reverse shell of the operating system. So for that, you will use hyphen hyphen os hyphen pwn and hyphen hyphen msf hyphen path. Over here, you have to give the path of your operating system's Metasploit framework. So in mine, it is stored inside opt hyphen slash Metasploit hyphen framework. In yours, it can be in some other directories. For that, you need to use the locate feature, locate or find command, right? So you have to do all these things by yourself. That is your homework. So you have Sunday, and I guess it will require only 4-5 hours of time, nothing more than that. And everything is super easy. A little patience is required. You need to read every single thing what your SQL map is saying, and you are good to go. You will have the data at the end. You will have all the password list. You will have the count. You will have all the usernames and password. You will have the reverse shell as well. That's what you have to do. If you have any question, just let me know. Let me know. And from the next week, for the whole week, we are going to study JavaScript and XSS, cross-site scripting attacks. So this will be a 1 week long topic. It can take one extra class as well. Like I will try to cover it up in 3 days. 3 classes, but it may take one extra as well. So see you guys in the next class, and make sure you do the homework. Now I hope you are going to enjoy that. So if you have any query, just let me know. You can type in the chat box, or you can also directly communicate to me. Yeah, tell me if you have anything. That's beautiful. Any question? By the way, I'll send you the PPT as well so that you can take reference from the PPT. And if you have any query, just let me know.